Hello and welcome to the Missing Presumed Death Quest Guide. On screen now is the map along with the recommended items, item requirements, and the skill requirements. There are no skill requirements, but the item requirements is at least some combat equipment, magic works fine, and the recommended items with the Ring of Slaying and Amulet of Glory. To start this quest off, we'll need to talk to the old man and start the core clue investigation. The core clues being the tree with an arrow stuck in it, the bush with the ring with the Saren symbol on it, and the monk that has the crystals embedded into his upper body. Do note that if it was an actual assassin, he would have cleaned that up and would not have made near as many mistakes. But once you find those core clues, talk to the old man that's covered in blood, and he'll talk about a witness up on the hill. So he'll send you up to the odd old man. So for the suspect interrogation, you'll need to persuade or threaten the person, so this one you'll have to persuade twice then threaten once, because if you just threaten with an unreasonable cause, he'll just be like, well, that's rude, and he won't talk to you. You have to go back and just chit-chat with him again. But once you finish that, just run back to the bloody old man, and he'll mention something about how, well, which way did they go, and it's three chat options with him. You have to go through all of it, quite honestly, and you can choose who you think it was, and I just went with Siliske. But for the second investigation part, you'll need to core clues would be a fence with a cloth, a bush that contains the Sarah Dolman pendant, and an elf that has the Sarah Dolman symbols, well, engraved into their hands. So for the suspect investigation of Blaze Sharp Eyes, you'll need to threaten him twice, and then he'll be completely terrified after mentioning, well, a couple things. But then you'll have to persuade him. After which, talking to the old man for a moment, he'll send you on your way to the wizard's tower to speak with one of his old friends. That is the easy part, at least. So let's head on to the wizard's tower, and we'll need to speak with the crystal mage. So for this one, you'll need to, the core answers that you actually need is just the first three options, and she'll take a look through your book and this and that. But after chit-chatting with her for a short time, she'll send you on your way back to the bloody old man. So for that, I recommend a Slayer ring and go to the Slayer Tower. If you have the agility level, just squeeze through the fence, and it's the quickest way to get back there. Once you get back, you'll have to be prepared for battle, because Itch Learner will show up, teleport off all the bodies, and you'll have to end up fighting four undead wights. I think that's how you pronounce them. There are four of them, they have an air weakness, and pretty much that's the simple truth for that. With an air weakness, that just means that, well, magic is the most effective one for this quest. I do recommend multi-target magic like Ancients with Barrage or Bursting. And eventually you'll find, after killing the fourth white, you'll find a invitation box with a mask on it. A bit of chit-chat gets involved, and Itchlearn gets a little insulted, but once you finish that, talk to Itchlearn and open the box near him, or her, and you'll teleport to Armadil's Citadel. So you can chit-chat with the generals, or just go ahead and jump right into the next sequence by talking to Itchlearn. I actually talked to a bunch of the people, that's why it was an hour-long unabridged video. So for this next part, the completion of this is running at 150% speed instead of 500%. You'll need to run around, go outside, hop across the rock, run across the planks, scale down the slope, scale up the other slope, and you'll be in the garden at least. In there you can find the emissary of Siliske. So what you'll need to do is climb through the obstacle, and you can go ahead and run on into the next room. I actually observed who she was, thought it was funny because she got stuck there like, why am I on this thing? Well, whatever. So the next room is the combat room. There are four melee and two range, I think. Yeah, it doesn't matter. They have a weakness between fire and slash, and do note that the enemies must be in these light spots that you see on the floor right now. So yes, it was two rangers and five melees? It doesn't matter. But either way, once you finish all of them off, you'll be able to go on and proceed to the next room. Upon proceeding to the next room, and I noticed that I have made a mistake that I said 6 and it's actually 7, but ignore that. It's actually 7 and they're weak. They scale to your level, but they're still weak. So pay no need to that. The simple 6/7 error. And you'll have to go to examine the window and you'll go to a cutscene. So the next room is the Shadowcaster room. For this one, you'll need to rotate the four Shadowcasters in each corner. In the bottom left, you'll need to rotate it once. In the top left, you'll need to rotate it twice. In the top right, you'll need to rotate it thrice. And in the bottom right, you'll need to rotate it once. That'll make a happy face looking kind of thing, and you'll see it in just a moment. And here we go. 1, 2, 1. It's basically a happy face. There we go. So what we'll need to do is examine the window again, and you'll get to be unlocking the next room, which is the Riddle Master. So riddle 1, the answer is sand, and the location of that is in chest number 1. Riddle number 2 is water, and its location is in chest number 2. The third and final riddle, the answer is shadow, and its location is in chest number 2 as well. It's not that big of an issue, but I do recommend just picking up the water and the shadow ones before you start the third riddle, so you can just use the shadow one on it and immediately get it over with. You'll eventually have to go. You'll get an invitation to access the nice fun that is the area where the boss is. Well, not boss, but Saliske's ascension, and I'm doing air quotes quite literally. So continuing on, I'm just including a cutscene that it's really messed up cutscene right now. I don't think I noticed all the NPCs were clipping here and there. There's the odd coloration there. So for this one, you'll need to free Death. And this one's pretty simple. He lets out a pissed off dragonkin, to say the least. And very least. So what you'll need to do is Ichlern will get in front of you and protect you with a shield. You'll need to actually stamp out the small flames on the floor. You'll see them as in like groups of 3 or groups of 4. But just stamp them out, and you'll run over to Death's Caves. Make sure you dodge the fireballs. If you get hit by a fireball or Ichlern's shield, Ichlern's shield falls, and then he or she gets hit by it, then you'll have to restart that phase over again, which is no issue because it's pretty short. But yeah, once you do that, run back to Ichlern, and Death will be proceeding following you, and you'll get the cutscene that I actually used for the intro for this video, which is Death saving you, quite literally. Because the shield goes down, Ichlern falls, Death's like, you know what, screw this, let's get out of here. And he does it in the most awesome way to do, by summoning his scythe. So once you do that, he'll teleport you out, you'll have a little bit of discussion, and Ichlern will mention that Saliske has his eye on you, and you'll have to go somewhere. But for that, you'll get the rewards for the quest, and more can be unlocked at higher levels. But I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you guys next week with another quest guide. Be sure to comment on what you want to see next. So, see you guys next time.